Good night, PNG, and welcome to Coca-Cola Sports Scene. Tonight we'll be looking at touch, cricket, rugby union, including both the public sevens and corporate netball competition. Also on hand, Ricky Berua, president of the Abau Amateur Boxing Association, gives his promotions on the upcoming international fight nights in March. Plus, the Habo Barramundis had their official welcoming after their brave showing at the ICC World Cup qualifiers. Well, it's been a busy weekend, so let's take a look at all the weekend action.
The rugby union and the Capital Rugby Union kicked off with great action at Monia Bava Park. Despite the first day anxiety, fitness levels were of little concern, as 16 teams in the men's pools and 6 in the women's braved the sizzling conditions to put on a good display of rugby. Following up on softball, Gazelle proved too strong for Kopex as United Brothers and Defence lead the way in the Potmosi Men's League. While for the Women's League, at the end of Game 5, Round 2, Stingers, Bears, Wantoks and Wolves share the top 4 in the A grade, and Stingers' younger B grade team leads by just a point over Yokomo as Gazelle and United Sisters languish at the bottom of the table. Netball was tight at Rita Flynn as the Public Servants Netball competition ended with its grand final day on Saturday. More than 60 teams began the competition, and the highlight match was between Works in Yellow against the determined Medcom NBC. The corporate netball competition also had its finals, semi-finals to be exact. Datec and the Australian High Com all battled it out in the Premier Division at Rita Flynn. The PNG Touch Federation conducted its final trial selections for both a male and female 14-man team to travel to Coffs Harbour and the Northern Territory in Australia, as well as participate in the Queensland State Championships. They are being sponsored by the PNG Sports Federation as part of preparations for 2015.
Jeremy Moggy there with our weekend sporting briefs. But before we go on our first break, let's take a quick look at the match between Gazelle and Kopex.
A total of 4 teams currently share second spot, and Gazelle needed a win to maintain their current placing. Kopex were hoping for an improvement in their form and looked set early on with good fielding. Gazelle, however, led by pitcher Le Karakau, were able to contain the Kopex attack. Gazelle were very determined and had good cover all over the diamond, winning 5-4.
Just luckily to scrape through. I think it's all come down to the boys' betting. The boys never back down. Just because the last 2-3 weeks, the boys have really picked up in betting. So yeah, the win was not too feeling, but the betting. So luckily we just scraped through. Melly's been pitching very well the last 3 weeks. So yeah, he's been pitching very well. I think it puts us in a very good spot from last year. Last year we were probably down below the bottom 5. So this year, yeah, I think we are probably second or third, I don't know. We'll try our best, but from the boys' betting, probably we'll do well.
Gazelle are under pressure to do well today, and a win would put them in good stead come the finals with a top 4 finish to qualify. If Yokomo wins, however, with their 2 games, that puts them in top spot, and they jump from 6th to 1st. With Brothers and Defence leading the way, Yokomo were intent on carrying on their momentum from their earlier win over PNG Power. Gazelle are under pressure to maintain their top 4 position, and a win would put them in good stead. However, if Yokomo wins, they end up in first place. With the competition very tight after 2 rounds, clubs will be counting on every hit they can get.
You're watching Coca-Cola Sports Scene, welcome back. Well, former PNG boxer and welterweight champion Ricky Berua took time to train elite boxing athletes down at Ella Beach over the weekend. Well, we managed to get a quick interview with him. Let's take a look.
Ready, set and shout, box.
Elite athletes took time to train with Mr. Ricky Berua, coach of Abau Amateur Boxing Association at Ella Beach yesterday morning. The training was part of preparing the athletes for the upcoming events this year, including the La Mana Fight Nights and the International Boxing Tournament, which will kick off next month, and the 2015 Pacific Games. The athletes trained on their leg movements and tricks, arms and shoulder techniques and skills, including high knee jumping moves. Training with Mr. Berua was Andrew Ummings from Bougainville, Tom Boga from Highlands, both from the NCD Boxing Association, and 16-year-old Bay Punoki from Abau District, representing the Abau Amateur Boxing Association.
I am organizing this international tournament between Australia and Papua New Guinea on the March 1st at Crown Plaza. I will be bringing three Australian boxers to fight our three local champions here.
So you're training them in preparation for that event?
Absolutely. I'm training these guys regarding that tournament coming up.
We've heard about the fight nights, La Mana Fight Nights. Are these three boys taking part?
Absolutely. These three boys are in the La Mana fights as well, because they are champions in their own right, in their own categories in the country.
The three boys are part of train-on squad for the 2015 Pacific Games and are doing their regular trainings with the rest of the team boxing in various locations around Port Moresby. Mr. Beru emphasized more on introducing boxing into his community in the Abau district of Central Province and is planning on building a boxing arena in Kupiano Station. Mr. Berua is planning on getting more youths from the village to get involved in boxing, and this also encouraged women to join in boxing in the near future. Ricky Berua there, coach and president of Abau Amateur Boxing Association. All five districts in the Central Province attended the week-long Central Provincial Games at Laloki on the outskirts of Port Moresby City. The purpose of the tournament was to select top athletes from the five districts of Central Province to have Team Central to represent Central Province in the PNG Games in Leh coming November this year. Athletes were chosen from different sporting codes, from ball games to field and track events. We were lucky enough to cover these and also managed to get an interview with Central Province PR John Yamo and the Central Provincial Administrator Gay Raga. Let's have a look.
Basically, during the opening ceremony, it was highlighted to all the competitors or all the participants from the five districts. Basically, we are looking at individual sports. In the last PNG Games, we didn't do really well in athletics. There were nil medals for athletics for Team Central and also from other ball games. So we are now trying to boost the athletics team in the field events. What Henry was saying, there are some good potential runners coming up. And also the other individual sports like weightlifting, which our team did really well in weightlifting also. They collected almost all the medals for Central Province during the Kokopo Games, and also the boxing.
Hiri, Goilala, Rigo and Abau, and most of the players that are participating here are from very remote and rural areas in those districts that came in to participate and be selected to represent the province.
The Central Provincial Games, and we wish the Team Central all the best in their preparations. We'll go for a quick break, so stick around. Welcome back to the show, and netball has been a rising sport in the country, with a lot more women from different backgrounds taking time off from work to enjoy the sport. The corporate netball competition was sizzling as they hit it out in their semi-finals over the weekend. We showcase tonight two of the competitors' big hitters and Daytech, going into their match as defending Premier Division champions against their battle-hardened Australian High Commission team.
With Datec heading in highly confident because of their higher winning rate and the great host of players at their disposal, captain Natanya Molina is hoping that in Monaco Nena, Kimberly Rawali and Rachel Kapi, they will prove to be no easy beats.
We've only gone once to a grand final. We actually made it to the top four only once, which was last season, and we won that premiership. So we're actually defending our title this season.
The current players that usually stand out in their performances would be our center, Kimberly Rawali. She's a current current representative of the PNG netball team. We also have Nancy Kapi, who's a former, she's now on the train-on squad for the PNG team. And we also have Rachel Kapi and Mona will be defending and shooting. So those are our main players we'll be banking on for this Sunday's win.
Now the Australians have said, bring it on. Do you have anything to say? Reply to that.
All I can say is may the best team win.
That's very humble of you.
Yeah, I guess so.
But the Australian High Commission team, led by Emily Flowers, will most likely be no easy pushovers coming in as underdogs. With goal attack Killer Park and shooter Rakara Raula having had great combinations the whole season, both will be hoping to be on target against Datec. Captain Killer Park, with her team backing her, have these words to say.
We played really hard as a team and we worked really hard to get this far, and I think credit to the girls, the team itself. Big achievement for us. Hopefully we can prove it, come out with a win.
How do you think the team will go through the game? I know Datec's got a couple of big heavy hitters with them.
It can work both ways. It depends on how we go out and play. I think we're going to go out and play our game. We discuss this through the season. We can go out and win it. You know, it's up to us. How they play is how they're going to play. We're not going to play their speed. We're going to play our game. And that should be a bonus to us, we think.
Now, you mentioned you've been here before.
Yeah.
Not here, but here. And do you think that would play in your favour?
We've been in the semis or the finals before, and I think, yes, it will. Because I think we've got experienced players in our team as well, and we can pull it out, come out with a win.
Datec will be looking to make it back-to-back finals, a feat only achieved once before by Brian Bell. And in coach Lua Rikis would be very confident. The game started off at a frenetic pace with good movement off the ball by AHC's Rakara Raula and Killer Park, constantly finding space behind sisters Nancy and Rachel Kapi and taking points every chance they had. Datec, however, have been in top form all throughout the competition and showed their class in the D as well. In the end, Datec won the match 27-21, and they have their sights set on the major semifinals next week against Westpac.
Also, as a footnote, Westpac and Proclean were in the other semi-final matchup. We'll go for a break now. Coming up on the other side, we have Jeremy with all your international sporting news. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook, like our page, or tune in to Hotspot every Thursday nights for all your latest sporting events in and around the country. Well, it's time for us to go. Next week, we'll bring to you more Capital Rugby Union footage, follow up on the Public Sevens netball, and find out how PNG cricket will cope with the resignation of Peter Anderson. Well, as always, viewers, please go grab yourself a Coca-Cola to satisfy your thirst. Until next week, right here, same time, same place, on Coca-Cola Sports Scene. I'm Godwin Eki. See you then.
get it popping, hot tamale. Dirty bass, we so bad about it. Ow. Too legit, we can't quit the party. Super freaks, no Illuminati. So, one, two, hit the booze. We on you, two, nothing to lose. So let it loose, cause the sheep don't sleep like pop, 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 pop. Drop low to the L.O. V.E. gotta get mo. So clap your hands, clap, clap your hands.
Got nothing but love to give.
Turned up, you don't hear me though. Here's a love for you stereo. So clap your hands, clap, clap your hands.
Got nothing but love to give.
We are one.
Turn it up now. Get it poppin', hot tamale. Dirty bass, we so bad about it. Ow. Too legit, we can't quit the party. Super freaks, no Illuminati. So, one, two, hit the booze. We on you, two, nothing to lose. So let it loose, cause the sheep don't sleep like pop, 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 pop.
Right.
Drop low to the L-O. V-E, gotta get mo. So clap your hands, clap, clap your hands.
Got nothing but love to give.
Turned up, you don't hear me though. Here's a love for you stereo. So clap your hands, clap, clap your hands. Get it poppin', hot tamale. Dirty bass, we so bad about it.
Ow.
Too legit, we can't quit the party. Super freaks, no Illuminati. So, one, two, hit the booze. We on you, two, nothing to lose. So let it loose, cause the sheep don't sleep like...